So from Wartburg, we welcome Miranda Murphy, Coach Amsbury, and Katie Summer. First, I would like to thank the three of you for being here. I know how difficult it is to come and talk after a hard loss. So thank you for being here. We truly appreciate it. First, I'll start with you, Coach. Talk about the game today, some of your thoughts and the reflection on your season.
Yeah, before I talk about the game, I just want to thank the committee and Rochester Sports and St. Mary's for putting on a great event. It was special, and our kids felt special. And then thanks to Knight Nation. People that followed us mean so much to us and packed this place. And they did that because of these guys and our group and the way we did it. And I told them in the locker room, we generated this much support. And I don't know, there's a lot of people out there supporting us that I don't even know. And that tells me that we did it the right way, that we're fun to watch, and that we've got great people. But on to the game, Bowdoin exposed us. And they exposed us in about every way that I couldn't even imagine. They're really good. And they earned that thing, and they were a lot better than we were tonight. All the credit goes to them. But, you know, I thought we made a good run at them, cut it to 10 coming out of halftime. And then we broke down and made a couple mistakes, and boom, it was right back to 20. And I got to give them credit for that. I don't think we gave up 90 all year. So they earned that. They attacked it really well, and they had a great shooting night. And then I thought maybe the biggest thing was, especially early, we didn't rebound very well. And when we did rebound well to start the third, we got going on offense. But they're good, and it should be a great game tomorrow.
What was Kelly doing? Eric Appen from the Pulse Bowl in Rochester. What was Kelly doing that gave you guys such difficulty trying to identify her on the outside especially?
Well, I think that she benefited from the rest of them. And we lost her because of how well they penetrated. And, you know, we were breaking down off the dribble. We didn't do a very good job containing the drive. And those other girls got in there and found her. And so I thought that was the biggest thing. But I'll give her credit that she knocked down shots. But the majority of those were contested. She's a great shooter. I just thought we needed to do a better job containing their life.
Katie, obviously you come into this game with a perfect record, and then you guys find yourselves down 16, 7 minutes in. How tough of a challenge is that, kind of being in that type of position where you hadn't been all season?
I mean, I had all the confidence in my teammates, and I told them, like, let's fight. We're fighters. We're going to do this. We're gonna keep fighting and not give up. And I'm so proud of them. We kept fighting, and it just didn't turn out our way.
It seemed like the turnover numbers were pretty high. What types of challenges did their defense present?
They were good. They were pressuring the ball pretty well, and I think we just got a little, I think we got panicked a little bit due to their pressure, and that's one thing I think we need to clean up, but I'm still so proud of this team.
Coach Amsbury, you've had a lot of prolific point guards in your tenure, starting with Holly Silby, culminating tonight with Katie Summer. What makes success in that position?
Well, Coach Jacobs has our point guard, so that's probably why. she does a great job with them, but Katie's a great player. And she was a great player from day one, and I think that, you know, she was able to, maybe more than any player I've ever had, was make everybody else way better. I mean, I've had other players that make everybody better, but not to the extent that Katie did. And, you know, I think if you added up her points and assists, how many of those assists were on threes, and I mean, she did so much for this program. But we've said it before that this group just complements each other so well, and, you know, I think our other players really feed off Katie's energy and her ability to set them up, and You know, if they don't knock down shots, she doesn't have almost 600 assists in her career too, but certainly been blessed with Katie and this whole senior class. I want to know, some of you researchers out there, figure out if any class in the history of Division III basketball has had 4 1,000-point scores, and I think that really speaks to their unselfishness and how together they were, and they really didn't care who scored the points. I'll miss these guys.
So let her keep going. Katie, especially because so many of you guys grew up playing together and grew up playing against each other in the same area, can you just describe what this run, especially this senior year, has been like for you guys?
I mean, yeah, like you said, growing up, we played against each other. We knew each other coming in. And getting to share this, like, these last four years with them is, I can't describe it. I mean, I'm just so thankful that I got the team I'm on, and I'm just blessed.
Coach, just what were your thoughts on kind of the challenge that their offense was going to present? Did you have feeling going into this game that you were going to be in store for a really tough test, especially with a player like they have that can come off the bench and shoot like that?
You know, honestly, I thought coming into this game we could defend them. I felt really comfortable with our game plan and felt like we could do a good job defending them, and we didn't. And a lot of that was them. They have so many players that can get you off the drive and just put so much pressure on you to contain the dribble. And then, you know, early when they hit all those shots and got confidence, then it gets even harder. Because then you're scrambling around and they get offensive rebounds. So we got exposed. I mean, we really got exposed. They're good. They're really good.
Miranda, I know Morgan was talking, kind of leading into this, that what you take away from the season was more than like a trophy or a photo and such. Can you talk a little bit about just kind of that culture and what's made this so memorable for this class?
Yeah, just from our freshman year to now, just to see the growth from everyone involved in the program and the community support that we've built throughout the years, and just tonight, you could even see in the stands, there's not an open seat behind our bench, and that's just a great atmosphere to be a part of, and there's just no one better than to have the girls next to us sitting there every day after day going to practice with, and just very fortunate for our team and the Wartburg program that is behind us.
Was this the quickest team you guys faced this year?
Yeah, I'd say overall probably. They were pretty athletic, yeah. But yeah, they're skilled too. And I thought they passed the ball extremely well when they got into the interior of the defense.
This one's for kind of whoever wants to take it, but what do you think the legacy of not just this senior class, but this group of Wartburg Knights is going to be?
This group's done so many things that no other Wartburg team has done. And first ever Final Four, and then 2 out of 3 years, first undefeated regular season, most wins. And I think there's a long, long list. But to me, it's not really about all of that. It's who we were. I think they sent a really good message to our younger kids, and one of our underclassmen spoke up in the locker room about the example they've set. And our number one goal was to have great championship culture. And my underclassmen spoke up and said, you guys did it the right way, you taught us how, and our number one goal remains to keep that championship culture. And I think that says a lot about this group.
Lastly, for the student athletes, what has playing basketball added to your overall Wartburg experience?
Yeah, it's been great. I'm very fortunate to be at Wartburg and just the support system that we have in our community and our families and just our teammates and coaching staff and everyone involved throughout the weekend. It's just been a great experience that we'll remember for the rest of our lives, and I'm just very blessed to get to play basketball this long and everyone stay healthy throughout the season.
I would say Wartburg wins basketball. You're a part of something bigger than yourself, and it's indescribable. And I only not have the best teammates, but I'm going to have lifelong friends. And Coach even said in the locker room, he's always going to have our back with anything down the road. And I'm just really thankful that we have these type of relationships.
Thank you, and congrats on the season, guys.
Thank you.